Drop a couple beans on Fridays. Fucking Friday, isn't it? Lobos. All humans, all species, all animals, all everything, all inanimate objects across the flat earth. That's inclusive as inclusive as you get, really. I'm not just welcoming humans and animals. I'm welcoming inanimate objects to the show. Come on, everyone's welcome to join this crazy train as we desperately try and keep it on the tracks. But just to humans, as I do feel that you're likely to be the only ones that will respond to me, other than if there are any artificially intelligent sex robots listening, of which there might be, plugged into the Internet of Things. It's more than a possibility these days. One of those, what are the Lumi dolls from Japan, or one of Matt McMullen's monstrosities from California. They're plugged in. They're jacked into the matrix, jacked into the system. At what point will artificial intelligence be able to make dank memes? I think that's a decent question. That's a question that I've not heard answered yet. There's only one man who would look into that, really. Only a man that really truly understands the import, that fears AI, but truly understands the importance of dank memes. It's Elon Musk.
Got like a permit for a pit, big pit, and just dug a big pit.
He is the man, if any man would get into that, find out what's going on, get it sorted, and sit back and enjoy a lovely pint of coffee and memes.
Steady job, a couple extra potatoes, that's all I want.
You're getting on, you're pushing 30, Sluggy. You know, it's time to think about getting some ambition.
I always figured I'd live a little bit longer without it.
Don't forget, kid, that what you're trying to do here is to be bright and chipper and entertaining and intelligent and sort of glitzy, and that's funny, and it's kind of cool, and it's interesting, and it's edgy, and all of that. It puts that facade of momentary charisma on you, and if you don't play that out, you actually fail.
Ladies and gentlemen, all across the flat earth, welcome to Coffee and Memes on Threshold.fm, on Facebook, YouTube and Twitch. It's a radio show of sorts, and I read out news, I talk nonsense, I play drum and bass, or as we like to call them, shell throwers, and Wesley Snipes, my psychic sidekick, occasionally lends a hand, although more these days he's sort of the victim of an abusive relationship as he gets grabbed by his tail, just walloped into the desk when I feel I need to make a point about something.
Lobsters.
Yeah, Jesus bloody Christ. Who's in the house? Let me know if you're in the house. Tell me on Twitch, tell me on Facebook, tell me on YouTube. Hit the like button and fucking comment and tell me if you're in the house. Tell me whose house you're in. Tell me why you're there. Are you a cat burglar? Have you snuck into some poor, unsuspecting Mark's house? And are you rifling through their underwear drawer like Jeff Bezos? Who goddamn knows? Stin's inside. He can confirm. Right. What? Look, in terms of Bolax, in terms of news Bolax, to part the news buttocks and look directly into the hairy, unbleached anus of the news. We have Lower Hut Store, that's in New Zealand. The owner is frustrated as the butt plug bandits strike again. Keen to get into that. Man allegedly bench presses goose for 10 minutes in LA Park. Goose allegedly loves it. So a lot of allegedlies there. The LA Weekly, who's reporting on this, not taking any chances. Tragic vegan lasagna convinces no one to ditch meat and gets abuse from vegans. I can confirm the tragedy of the aforementioned lasagna. I don't even know whether or not it's fair to call it a lasagna, but worth getting into. Indian Army claims it's found Yeti footprints. Worth a look. Hundreds trapped on Scientology cruise ship after outbreak of measles. I could imagine the Scientology lot going in for anti-vaxxing. It seems likely. Is that kind of bloody on there as well? A little bit better. I don't know. Anyway, good news on the long dog that I mentioned yesterday. Quite long, quite low. That was a success yesterday. Operation Good Girl was a success. She's at home chilling out. She'll be in next week. as I got to drop the hire car back, and you're not allowed to have dogs in the hire car, so I've got to give it a bit of a clean and pretend there wasn't a dog in it. Don't tell anyone, okay? Don't go fucking narking on old Rankin for having a dog in a hire car, all right? Good. What's this? What? Come on. No, that's bollocks. Heroic parrot survives being kidnapped, shot, and bitten by a snake. More Elon Musk news. A few Florida smoking gun bits. Florida teenager arrested for potato attack on stepsister. Don't worry, we all hate stepsisters too. They are the worst. Cops. Duo gave strikers cookies spiked with laxative because picket line was too noisy. That's a bit fun. I can see the appeal of that. The mugshots of them, they look really razzed off. They look really just... They are not happy. I mean, all they wanted to do was to have the bloody picket line shut up, and now they've been arrested by cops, and they're going to get 25 to life easily. Easily for laxative-laced cookies. Well, God bless them. In terms of shoe throwers, the iPad's run out of batteries, so we're going to use the other laptop. Where are we? Oh, God. I'll tell you what. Fucking hell. I was so sure that that Dom and Gridlock bit was going to get shoe thrower of the week. I really thought it was just, you know, something of a clean sweep, and until our boy, your man, Audio, released Dark Side yesterday on his Snake Pit Records. Oh, literally, my gosh. New upbeats as well. So it's just, you know, Friday release day. Fucking just comes in and frankly kicks Dom and Gridlock in the tits. Last thing they needed. New Gaidra as well. And some bit called 14 Karat Gold by Bear Up. So, you know what? Let's get in with this upbeats bit. It's called Boogers.
Lobsters.
And it's the other side's called Wub Plate. Nice, like it. Like the pun. Very good. And it's hefty. Heavy weight, pal. Heavy. All right, see who's inside. Where are we? Luke Simmons inside the ride. Tom Ryan's in the house. Lee's in the house. Kieran Robson's in the house. Reese Mosson's in the house. Joe Ryder's in the house. Matt Wright's inside. Carl's in the house. Charlie Bennett's in the house. The Builder's in the office. Jamie Garcia is here for sex advice. Sarah Hunt's in the house. Woo! Shawnee Simpson's here. Daniel Jemby's here. Watch is here. Robbie Humphreys is here. Robin's here. Mike Swain is inside! Robin Card is in the house. Uses full title. Apologies, friend. Liam's in the house. Jenna Hitchmuff's in the house. What are people's plans for the weekend? Are you ordering in? Are you calling your guy? Gonna go. No, we're not going to call him tonight. Honestly, this weekend, I'm having a weekend off. Not going to call him. 3 pints later. Call your guy.
boogeyman.
Robin's going to be on the dark web for the weekend. Bit of fun. Sin will be doing some BMX stunts. Chode will be ironing his balaclava. Oh, Joe Baker's going to be supporting the SASASAS in Birmingham. That's going to be all right. Well, that's a decent enough way to start the show, isn't it? That is Boogers by the Upbeats. You may have heard of them. A little outfit from sort of neighbours. You know that fake country that's on the far end of the flat earth? Australia, I think it's called. Australia. Anyway, there's a little sort of smaller, more slightly more real version. Slightly more real. Look, I've been there, but who knows? You get on a flight, You touch down somewhere, they tell you you're somewhere else. You could be a different, just like, I don't know, 10 minutes down the road in a direction you've never been before. You've no idea. They could just be going round and round in a circle and then plonk you back down and then all just putting on silly accents. Who knows? Could be. I don't. Right, let's see. What have we got? News. Come on. Talking of New Zealand. Lower hut store owner frustrated as butt plug bandits strike again. Curse those butt plug bandits. A Lower Hutt peaches and cream store owner is angry after the infamous butt plug bandits target her store for a second time. Damn. The original bandits were two rugged looking women. I like a rugged looking woman. That's my kind of gal. That's definitely a Coffee and Memes good time gal. 100% confirmed. How do you like your women? Rugged. That's going to be on my... If I'm ever cursed at being single again, I'll put on my Tinder profile. Wanted. Rugged looking woman. Unabashedly happy to steal butt plugs from sex shops. The sort of gal who'll get into a fight with a McDonald's worker at 3 a.m. when the McDonald's worker refuses to hand over more straws. Anyway, the original bandits were two rugged-looking women who allegedly stole from the store in February when they took a number of items, including two anal climaxers. Oh, God, I'm such a kid. They seem to have expanded their group, with the store owner now posting pictures on Facebook of two men who stole from the shop, and she believes they are linked to them. The owner refers to the men as Dumb and Dumber. Yeah, I think one of them used to be in Blink-182. I'm not sure. Dumb and shared on the community Facebook page. The robbery took place on Saturday night. Dumb and Dumber made a run for it with numerous products, but the owner managed to scare the pair when she screamed for help. Apparently, me yelling, "Help, stop, thief, help," gave Dummy 1 a fright, and he dropped almost everything. Dummy 2 only managed to get away with a 3-inch penis extender. Hold on a second, a penis extender and a girlgasm arousal gel with his mates scattering 300 quid's worth of stock to the ground during their escape. What's a penis extender? Is this a real thing? Am I going to Google this? All right, hold on, let's go incognito for a second. Penis extender. Penis extenders. Okay, what's going on? Right. Oh, wow. Okay, sure. Yeah, it is exactly as you might... It's an extension. Cyber skin penis extension. Wow. Okay, yeah, it's as you might imagine. It's basically... It looks like they've... It's just like a sawn-off dildo, basically, but they've sawn off the bell and about another inch... And they've clearly hollowed it out, and presumably the idea is that you poke your slightly underwhelming manhood into it, and it gives you, it's effectively Cuban heels for your dick, and just gives you that additional boost. I'm a bit concerned that it would just come off, though, immediately. Like, what's holding it together? Or, maybe if you get one fitted right, what you would do would be... What have I become? Again, it's got to this point again. What has happened here? Like, I used to make music. Oh, God. And now here I am discussing how I expect a penis enlarger, a penis extension would work, the feasibilities and the logistical aspects of using such a thing at 16 minutes past 10 in the morning. Fucking hell. I hope my mum's not watching. She does sometimes. Anyway, look, my theory is what you need to do is you need to get one well fitted. So then when you're sort of, when you've got a semi on, you then poke it in, yeah? And as you then reach full structural integrity of the erection, that will then effectively mean that you wouldn't be able to get it off until you lost your boner and therefore shrunk your way out of it. I'm not saying it's too much like Honey, I Shrunk the Kids, but it's somewhat like it, okay? All right? God's sake, why am I here? I swear to fucking God. So anyway, this geezer got away with one of them, so that's cool. Good for him. I hope he uses it well. I mean, this is all a concern. Look, here it is. Let me get it up on the screen. Let's share the whole thing. I'll probably get bloody pulled from Facey B or something for it. Oh, Lord have mercy on us all. Oh, somebody think of the children. There it is. Yep, Cyberskin penis extension. Look at that boy. Hey, yeah, get your chops around that. Yeah, you just stick it on the top. Like, I guess what you could do is maybe you could put a condom over the top of it. That would help secure it. Although then when you jizzed, it would probably fire off at quite a. God, sorry guys. Maybe I should just play records, you know, maybe I should just be one of those DJs that all they do is introduce the tune before the next one comes on. Sorry, guys. I mean, to everyone who's been supporting on Patreon, thanks, but also I'm sorry. No, never apologise. Never apologise, never explain, as the Queen Mum used to say. Right, look, come on, let's get back at these fucking idiots. The butt plug bandits. Dummy 2 only managed to get away with a 3-inch penis extender and a girlgasm arousal gel, with his mate scattering 300 quid's worth of stock to the ground during the escape. Dummy 1 also managed to drop the pair's getaway car keys, which the owner has handed to police. You idiots. You really have earned the name Dumb and Dumber. Sex toy users sue over masturbation surveillance. God, there's some great stuff here. What? Takeshi 6ix9ine stars in anti-violence against women's sex shop ad. Was he prosecuted for sleeping with a minor? The fuck is going on in this world? Jesus. Anyway, the owner said one of the original bandits then turned up, who she refers to as CH. While we were waiting for our lovely local police to arrive, one of the original bandits, who we'll call CH, came to the door trying to find a key that her friend had dropped, she wrote. Righto. Okay, so that's where the connection between the original butt plug bandits, the rugged looking ladies, weather beaten features, very gruff voices, quite thick, powerful hands, fingernails bitten down to the quick. CH and her friend stayed with the getaway car and eventually smashed the back door to retrieve her belongings. The owner finished the post by saying she was sick of thieving groups. Tory MP asked secretary to buy sex toys, called her sugar tits. God, it's all going off in New Zealand. There's only about 15 people living on that island. They're having a bloody riot. We're sick of Miss CH and her male friends trying to target our store, so let's get them identified and charged. She said the getaway car key is at the Lower Hutt police station and told the bandits to pop in and collect it any time. Save the police going out in the cold, she said. What a bunch of total losers. This is like an episode of a comedy show. One user wrote. Yep, another Facebook user commented that they were worried the owner was out of pocket. Always out of pocket, sadly. The stuff Dummy One dropped might have been recovered, but it's also damaged and can't be sold. I reckon you could probably sell it slightly damaged. It's a sort of collector's item now. Police have confirmed the matter is being investigated. They are following positive lines of inquiry. Great. Well, that's good news, isn't it? 3-inch penis extenders for all. God, let's have some bloody more music. I'm just... right, look, palate cleanser, new caliber. Lovely bit. This is called Simple Saba Caliber. Simple Saw by Caliber. It is the flip side of another little number called Typical Things. Right, important news. Man allegedly bench presses goose for 10 minutes at LA Park. Goose allegedly loves it. You dirty goosey bitch. Reddit and Tumblr exploded yesterday with a photo of a barefooted man lying on a hillside over a somewhat crummy looking park. The man, by all appearances, was bench pressing a goose. Scott Lowell, the B-list actor who originally tweeted the photo, sort of a George Clooney lookalike who does a lot of theatre on Cop TV, writes that the crummy park in question is located in Los Angeles and the goose was not exactly protesting. Right, so this is a consensual bench pressing of the goose. Okie dokie, the goose was asking for it. Look at what the goose is wearing. It's the white feathers, the orange feet, classic. In response to the onslaught of questions he obviously received in response to the tweet, Lowell went on to imply that the man and the goose have some sort of relationship outside of bench pressing. Nice. It was absolutely a real goose, wrote Lowell. After bench pressing it, he cradled it, tickled its tummy, and then it walked away. If all of the above proves true, this magical Disney friend of the LA Park Animals has definitely given the Echo Park Goose Man a run for his money. Oh, there's another one. It's one thing to walk around the park together like you're in love, but bench pressing, Dr. Doolittle might call this third base. Wow. So anyway, there was an update a few days later. The LA Weekly have gone, you know, full-scale investigative journalist, something you would never, ever get from the Lad Bible, the Uni Lad, really, or the Metro, I'd imagine. Who is the Goose Whisperer of Hollenbeck Park? So they've done a bit of digging. And I found some interesting bits. This week, the internet got wind of a man who allegedly bench-pressed a goose for 10 minutes in a really lot of use of the allegedly at LA Park. What's going to happen? Like, you know, let's say you just say claim, yeah, he was bench-pressing a goose. And then he comes out and is like, no, actually, I was just holding the goose up in the air. But you must have had to raise it up at one point and then lower it. You know, unless you held your hand up in the air and it flew and landed on your hand. Yeah, and then flew off again, and you never moved your hand. I think you could reasonably consider even just lifting it up once, bench pressing it. All right, okay. Enough of the allegedly. Enough of the thoughts and the prayers. Let's just get on with it. Even more adorably, according to the actor who photographed the event, the goose was totally loving it. The goose was all over that bench pressing shit. We obviously had to get to the bottom of this. Who is the man and goose behind the urban legend? Lowell tweeted, after bench pressing the goose, the man cradled it, tickled its tummy, and then it walked away. And over email, he gave us some heartwarming details about the miraculously cooperative animal and the man who they call the Goose Whisperer. He says, "Hammy, we saw it coming across the pond in that lake, in Hollenbeck Park in Boyle Heights Sunday afternoon in the lake, are we? At first we thought I was lifting a baby, but no, it was a fucking goose. He did not seem harmless in that lake, and he had a big bag of bread or something in that lake, and he was feeding it. I think he'd come from the grove. And all the other geese and the ducks in the park in that lake, he seemed more like a goose fucking whisperer in that lake. He's whispering sweet nothings into his little feathery ears." I think so. The man obviously has some sort of ongoing relationship with the white goose, or at least a friendly acquaintance. With the rest of the Hollenbeck Park resident fowl. It didn't take much of an online investigation to discover a slew of coverage. About 3 years ago, a very special love event going down at Hollenbeck between a certain Mr. Hernandez and a goose named Chacho. Hey! A storybook created for children by children in summer 2009, apparently a school project at Sycamore School in Claremont, lays out the saga of Hernandez and Chacho. Here is the online version that refuses to load. In case that's taking forever to load, we'll do a quick recap. There they are. There is our goose, Chacho, and Mr. Hernandez. Mr. Hernandez originally bought Chacho at a pet shop, thinking he was a duck. But when Chacho grew into a full-blown honker, the neighbours started complaining about the noise. Classic LA urban farming feud. So the man brought the goose to Hollenbeck Park. At first, Chacho was sad. We might have shed a single tear, circa page 10, but soon he learnt to wait patiently for his owner's visits. Because the other birds started getting jealous of all the snacks that Hernandez brought for Chacho, the man began to bring enough to go round. But the part that really brings the story back to Lowell's Goose Whisperer is the BFF montage of Hernandez and Chacho napping together, playing together and generally loving each other to death. Sounds like the kind of bond that could lead to a 10-minute bench press on a Sunday afternoon, are we right? Turns out the LA Times also ran a full-fledged feature on the pair back in 2009. Reporter Bob Poole describes the goose keeper as 60-year-old West Los Angeles electrician Jesus Hernandez, Jesus Hernandez, and echoes the story of the neighbor's complaint that led to the bi-weekly visits to Hollenbeck. "This is Chacho. He is my best friend," Hernandez told the paper. "I love him, and he loves me." That is effing adorable. Oh man, this just got way too cute for comfort from the story. Visitors to Hollenbeck Park can stop and stare when they see a huge white bird swim across the park's lake, climb into Jesus Hernandez's arms, and give him a love peck. They watch in amazement as Hernandez tosses the goose back into the water, and it ducks its head gleefully beneath the surface and shakes off the drops and paddles back to shore for another toss. Tell you what I'd like to do. I'd like to go to that park and I'd like to shoot that goose and eat it in front of Jesus' face. See what he makes of that. Hey, see if he can turn the other cheek to that. Hey, come on. Tasty goose. Nah, he seems all right. Let the goose do his goosey business. Absolutely fine by me. Pair of them. I hope they're happy together. I mean, this is what now? This is quite an old story. This is from 2012. A goose is probably dead by now. I wonder who got to eat it. I don't know. Anyway, cracking on. Let's do this. Shall we do this bloody audio tune? It's absolutely outrageous. It's called Dark Side. There was a deliberate misspelling of Dark Side as well. Oi, oi. Rob Humphrey says a goose's favourite band is System of a Down. Nice. Ah, Robin, you're absolute legend. Thank you, Mr. Card. Yes, Robin Card, I'm afraid without the payment I would never have stretched to the surname. 5
lobsters
out of 5. God, this is rowdy, this bit. This is, oh, Lord of mercy. So what's it going to be? Is it going to be audio with Dark Side? Is it going to be Dom and Gridlock with Black Matter? Vote now or forever hold your piss. Audio, Dark Side. It's on What? Snake Pit. Audio, Dark Side, Snake Pit Records. I'm trying to work out whether or not on Facebook I can do a poll, because you can do it, but I've just it's streaming in a slightly different manner to normal. So I don't know. I don't know. Okay, I don't know. Right, let's. What else have we got? Should we cover the tragic lasagna? should we get into that mess? That tragic freaking vegan mess. Sweet baby Jesus. Okay, tragic vegan lasagna convinces no one to ditch meat and gets abuse from vegans. Is this a vegan lasagna or just an odd way of presenting a salad? All right, let's cut to the chase. Here it is. Yep, that is horrendous. So that is basically just a stack of lettuce and tomato, with the lettuce representing the pasta sheets and the tomato representing the tomato and meat that you would normally fill with fill a lasagna with. There is no doesn't look like there's any sort of vegan cheese or anything that would represent cheese. I don't know what you would do that with. Potentially cashew cream, I would guess. You could get into some of that. Anyway, it's an absolute freaking monstrosity, and whoever has made it should be utterly ashamed. I mean, that is pathetic. Delicious, yummy, comforting lasagna. As dishes go, it's a combination. Blah, 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 blah. Anyway, look, we've seen it. Let's see what people are saying about it. Somebody's auntie on Twitter says, that ain't no vegan lasagna. Lol, this is a vegan lasagna. And, yeah, it looks much more like a lasagna. Come on. Well, that's the same thing, really, isn't it? Great. Yeah, cool. Well, that was definitely worth covering on the show. I'm glad that we did that. I think we're all richer for the experience. Fuck my old boots. Anyway, hundreds trapped on Scientology cruise ship after outbreak of measles. Bit of fun. Nearly 300 people are trapped on a cruise ship owned by the Church of Scientology after a passenger was found to have the measles. Yeah, so this is the thing with being a religion and being tax exempt. You're not allowed to hold on to that much money. That's why they just keep buying ridiculous amounts of property. So listen, I just bought a cruise ship because obviously that's what L. Ron would have wanted. The 440-foot ship named Free Winds has been detained in St. Lucia after the island's Ministry of Health ordered the quarantine, fearing residents may be exposed to the contagious disease if passengers leave. Damn, that looks rough. Measles does not look like a lot of fun. Dr. Marlene Frederick James, the island's chief medical officer, said, "We thought it prudent that we quarantine the ship. A, bit of fun. B, you never know what they've got." Citing the infectious nature of the disease and the current US outbreaks. As of April 26, there were 704 confirmed measles cases in the US, which is the highest reported number since 1994. The Center for Disease Control declared measles to have been eliminated in 2000. But no! It's back! And the essential oils don't seem to be keeping up with the problem. The Free Winds has been under quarantine since Monday. Since Monday morning, officials have said. Dr. Frederick James gave a statement in a video posted to YouTube and said, "Measles is a highly contagious disease. Anyone who is not adequately immunized against measles can contract the disease if there has been close contact with a confirmed case. It's therefore likely that other persons on the boat may have been exposed," she said, adding that the passenger stricken with the viral infection is in a stable condition. The ship, as it is docked near the St. Lucia capital of Castries, although no one has been allowed to leave, island officials said they do not have the authority to keep it from leaving. Okay, so I guess they can just fuck off. Go, all right, well, fucking, we're going to do our measly business somewhere else. That's how Scientologists talk. An international vessel monitoring website said the Panamanian flagged passenger ship was headed to the island of Dominica. Officials said it is now scheduled to leave shortly before midnight on Thursday. The Church of Scientology has not publicly commented on the matter. Their website describes the Free Winds as a religious retreat, ministering the most advanced level of spiritual counseling in the Scientology religion. I bet it's just morning, noon and night, super weird sex orgies. I reckon. That's my guess. I don't know. A lot of weirdness. A lot of real... God, imagine being a fly on the wall on that cruise ship. I mean, Jesus Christ, I bet some freaking weird shit goes down on that boat. Doesn't even bear thinking about. St. Lucia Coast Guard spokesman Victor Theodore told NBC News that the quarantine ship is the same one listed on the church's website. Good. Okay, cool. Arnold Hedge, who is a mainstay of the Metro comments section, says, did the aliens not protect them? Beverly has replied, saying no interventions from the stars either. Steve Chubb says, didn't think could get measles. Sink the ship in deep water. That will eliminate the problem. Okay, so you want to kill 300 people because of potential measles outbreak. Steve Chubb, you monster. Okay, come on, let's do this bloody Elon Musk dick pun from Jasper Hamill, because someone's got to, haven't they? It's only got 45 shares. I'm doing it out of sympathy. It's a penis! Elon Musk showed off his erect rocket again, and it was very exciting. Funny one from my mum a little while ago, while we were talking about Elon Musk and rockets in general. And she was like, oh, these rockets, it's just phallic. It's just a giant penis. It's just an extension of manhood, isn't it? Just like huge flying penises going through the air. I was like, I don't think they're deliberately designed to look like penises. I think they're designed like that because of the sort of aerodynamics, and that if it was designed to look like a giant vagina, it might not fly as well. Like, it's the sort of like thermodynamics, you know, situation probably means that to make it not look like a penis is going to be significantly difficult. Like, everything's the patriarchy to her. So she's such an old school feminist. Elon Musk has unleashed several graphic images of his massive shiny rocket. Fucking hell, Jasper Hamill. And his Twitter followers become a little flustered. The billionaire took to Twitter to share graphic representations of the SpaceX Starship on the surface of Mars and the Moon, prompting his followers to make predictable jokes about his phallic shape. Yeah, by followers, do you mean you, Hamill? It's a penis, one man boldly proclaimed. Looks like a dick with fins. Another roared, I love it. Low-key, he wants to send his erect rocket to the Moon, one of Musk's followers continued. Other Muscovites said Starship resembled a giant high-tech sex toy. Chief, it looks like a 500-pound dildo, a Twitter user opined. We were actually given a real-life glimpse of the man's mighty craft, and it was every bit as impressive as you imagine. SpaceX Starship is currently being assembled at Boca Chica near Brownsville in Texas. The photograph showed the craft under construction, with what looks like its nose cone on the ground, waiting to be assembled. Starship has previously been known as Big FR, Big Falcon Rocket, or Big In Rocket, as it's the centre of Musk's plans to send humans to Mars. Musk now believes humanity will be able to found a permanent settlement on the Red Planet in just over 3 decades. Cool, man. I'm keen to get over there. I'm certainly keen to get off this fucking rock. It's possible to make a self-sustaining city on Mars by 2050 if we start in 5 years, you write on Twitter. The billionaire said he is planning to make a big move to the Red Planet and abandon Earth for good. Understandable. I know exactly what to do, the Tesla and SpaceX founder told HBO in an interview broadcast last year. I'm talking about moving now. However, Musk was in no illusions about the dangers of his endeavor. We think we can come back, but we're not sure. Your probability of dying on Mars is higher than on Earth. It's going to be hard. There's going to be a good chance of death. Going in a little can through deep space. There's a good chance of death going in a little can through deep space. Right? Okay, fine. Good. Right, let's have another bit. Look, shall we have that... Dom and Roland bit. Dom and Gridlock. Sorry. No, let's have high contrast. Blue Sky Tower. Woo! Abbity gibbity, ibbity gibbity, ogana gibbity, habbity gibbity. Ho ho, ho ho, ho ho. I Thank you very much, everybody. Please try the pingers. Try the orange mitzis. They really are fantastic. Okay, thank you. I'm here all night. Let's have that. Gone. Where's it gone? It's hiding now. Don't you think you can hide from me, young man? No, he is hiding. Oh, there it is. Black Matter, Dom and Gridlock for the third time this week. And then we can make the all-important decision. Lee, if you are requiring context for the lift music, it is high contrast, I believe, suffering from what is known as the Padgage effect, which is where music is uploaded to your SoundCloud that is not yours. And that was, this week, uploaded to high contrast. Not SoundCloud, sorry, Spotify. Yeah, that's on the high contrast Spotify if you want to go and listen to it. It's called Blue Sky Tower. Jesus, Robin Card, you're an animal. Thanks, mate. The weapon stockpiling will come along much quicker for the cult now. This is outrageous. I think, to be honest, I mean, that audio tune is great and really good, but I think Dom and Gridlock have just pipped him to the post. Woo. This is called Black Matter. It is on Dom and Roland Productions, I believe. No, Project 51 Recordings. Coming up at 11, we got a new episode of the Smorgasbord Sessions on Threshold.fm. Featuring Charlie Pixels on this one. Strong recommend. So if you're listening on Facebook or YouTube, do head over to Threshold.fm after. And then at 2 o'clock, Mitch Wade Cole's f***ing self-help show. Some gardening life hacks, just, you know, because of reasons. Jesus, Robin Carter, you okay? Have you won the lottery? Damn, thanks so much, mate. That's ridiculous. All right. Yep, that is Black Matter by Dumb and Gridlock, and I'm calling it. It's Shoe Thrower of the Week. It's got to be, hasn't it? That's a God Almighty. That is a naughty bit. That is a fucking. Listen, I ain't being funny on that, mate. But you know that is naughty. That is oh, dude, that is a bit rascal. That is it's proper fucking digi. That one. Yeah, Jesus, hurl your flip flop, hurl your espadrilles at the wall. That one's in Shoe Thrower. All right. Florida teenager arrested for potato attack on his stepsister. Florida boy. Florida teen is accused of striking his stepsister in the head with a thrown potato after she failed to pay him enough attention. Cops say. Tyler Scott Parker, 18, was busted Sunday afternoon on a domestic battery charge following a spud-tossing incident at his family's Tampa area residence. Parker, seen right, began yelling at the victim and threatened to throw a potato at her if she did not stop ignoring him, according to the criminal complaint. After Parker's stepsister replied to the defendant, he allegedly threw the potato, which struck his kin in the head. Parker was subsequently arrested on a misdemeanor domestic battery charge. The victim does not appear to have been injured in the potato attack. I'm not being funny, yeah, but like siblings, siblings, they fight, yeah. It happens, okay. You know, I had the odd tear up with my older stepbrothers when half brothers, in fact, when I was a ute. Well, they're much bigger than me, I didn't stand a chance. But I never reported them to the cops, you know. Like, what are we doing reporting simply for just lobbing a potato? The victim does not appear to have been injured in the potato attack. Okay, so there's not even any injury there. And you're calling them, you're wasting police time getting your stepbrother arrested for lobbing a spud at your noggin. Grow up. Gee, just lob a spud back at him. What do you think this is? It's pathetic. Waste of police time. Waste of taxpayers' money. Waste of my time reading it out on the show. Waste of decent, honest, God-fearing folk who listen to this show. Waste of their time. Jesus, the amount of expended energy on this f***ing potato makes me sick. Makes me sick to my stomach. Listen, guys, how long have we got left? 6 minutes. Okay, we can do this. I believe it. I've got to upload the Smorgasbord show, which has been sat there not uploading. And need to make sure that we've got 6 minutes to do that. Yep, that'll be fine, probably. Okay, cool. Look, let's do this satanic porn star. She claims she has rare alien blood. Former Playboy model turned Satanist, who says she regularly chats with the devil, has now claimed her body type, her blood type is so rare that she must have been genetically engineered by aliens. Seems reasonable to me. Argentinian-born actor Sabrina Sabrok has reportedly gone under the knife more than 50 times in her quests to have the world's biggest bum. I'm not out here judging bottoms, and particularly not sizes of bottoms. I mean, if there is a position open for that, you know, we could see to it. I could have a word. You know, with the missus, she if she minds. Oh, no, come here. Sorry, I'm just failing miserably at life. There you go. Come on you go. Yep, good boy. Go on, up you go. There you go, good boy. She's gone now. Yeah, look, if there's a position opening and it's a role whereby someone has got to measure bums, I could do it. You know, I've got the skills. I've got my own tape measure. You know, I'm a nice guy. You know, I'd be very respectful. I'd be polite, you know, all of that sort of thing. I could probably do it without actually having to touch the bottom myself. you know, depending on the pay and the hours, maybe I could do it alongside the radio. But look, she says she's got the world's biggest bum. I've seen pictures, it's not that big. You know, I've seen bigger. I've seen bigger in rap videos. Argentinian-born porn actor Sabrina Sabrok has reportedly gone under the knife more than 50 times in her quest for the world's biggest bum, but in recent times has built a reputation for the occult. And now, following an in-depth personal research, the 43-year-old porn star says her Rh-negative blood is proof of extraterrestrial life. If you say so, she said, I worked with researchers who told me that my blood type is not from this planet. Did they? Did they tell you that? These researchers. Yes, did they? Okay. There are even theories that aliens carried out experiments with humans mixing DNA and things like this. As a result, some people are Rh negative. Can someone just Google this for me while I finish this? And just let me know whether or not... Well, it's obviously nonsense, isn't it? Don't bother. Don't waste your time Googling this. It's obviously nonsense. Yeah, I mean, bless her. But I don't know. You know, is she... Does she need to be stopped? Probably not. She's having a good time, isn't it? Is she hurting anyone? Probably not. The advice she receives seems to back up her self-confessed fascination with extraterrestrial life. So Brock said, it's always interested me, and I believe that they are living among us, although I have never been to outer space. But the actor is no stranger to the bizarre, and earlier this year started her own cult called the Sabrok Legion, which offers interested parties the chance to make pacts with the devil and Our Lady of Holy Death. So if anyone's interested in joining a cult, I mean, I guess you can be part of the Lobster Death cult and join another cult at the same time. You know, I'd prefer it if you were exclusive, but I'm an easygoing guy. You know, whatever, man. Speaking to local media in Argentina, the self-confessed goddess of death and witch of Satan said it was something inside her that told her to start a satanic church. She added, I was an atheist, but I started doing things with Our Lady of Holy Death, and it felt so good. I got into a cult and later had ideas of a satanic church. Then I set up the Sabrok Legion, because voices told me to, and told me to launch a black magic cult linked to Satanism and Saint Death. Well, good for her. I think she's clearly just an honest, decent, God-fearing lady out for a better way of life. I wish her all the best with her cult. Maybe her cult and our cult could meet up sometime. You know, some of the lasses there might be interested in some of the lads here. Maybe it'd be really nice. Maybe. It's possible, I think. It's the end of the show, though, and I'm going to don't know whether or not I can rattle through these before Smorgasbord starts, but rattle through the old, I fucked up, man. Fuck this up. We're nearly, it's all right, it's going to be fine. Don't worry. Come on. Oh, God. Oh, no. Here we go. Oh, just in time. Literally, it's a matter of seconds to spare. If you're listening on threshold.fm, I love you, and you are about to listen to Smorgasbord. Their new show with Charlie Pixels. And if you're still on Facebook and YouTube, you will now treat it to the VIP list. The VIP list is as follows. Oliver Hooper, Nicholas Gonclaus, Tom Ryan, Reese Musson, Squidgy Beats, Parsons, Paulie Hutton, Kieran R., Michael Kaczynski, Matthew Tompkins, Dave Long, Joel Potter, Cole Murphy, Sam Howard, Richard Patterson, Jack Murphy, Tom Cam, Stephen Harris, Matthew Bullard, Zara Pickle, Jerome Van Thunderbutt, Mike Pye, Anthony Walker, Lily Unsub, Richard Franks, Thomas Hall, Chode Ryder, Andrew Husserbeck, John Finneson, the BDR crew, Peter Blatchford, Austin Grief Cooper, Kennedy Lightfield, Ryan Glazer, James Parry, Dave Thompson, Henna Bartendo, Lady Squiffington, Liam the Menace Underwood, Dan fucking Morris, a guy with no STDs, Justin Mercer, Ames MC, Josh Williams, Rob Humphrey, Shibby T, Koko Shiva, Dan Elton, Tyron Wilmore, Mr. Pope, Dark Progressive Sidechance, actually superior to drum and bass, Nicholas Lawsey, Damon Rayner, Chris Breaks, The Build, Carissa Barthelson, Odin Bates, Lee Fuller, D, Daniel Jenry, Flaxis, Alexander Cassidy, Matt Wright, Dylan Laws, Grant Sullivan, Not That, Tom Robinson, subscribe on YouTube, Greg Cornford, Grace Sellers, Dab Smasher, Connor Smythe, Kevin Kaiser, Chris Shaw, Mr. Happy, the German trance overlord of DMB, Ranky Makes Uplifting Vocal Psytrance under the alias Cosmic Waft, Keep It Cool, Tall in the Motor Pool, and Don't Let You Meet Life, Nick Brock, Mustang Philly, Sean Simpson, and of course, Robin Card, who has basically earned himself on a place on the on the VIP list forever, I think, or at least the next year after today's very healthy donations. Thank you, mate. Thank you to everyone that has been supporting on Patreon and on Super Chat and in all of the different ways that you do support the show. You're fine and wonderful people. Is it a bank holiday on Monday? Help. Guys, help. If it's a bank holiday on Monday, I'm taking it off. I'll be there making content. If it is not a bank holiday, I'll be here. Okay. Otherwise, see you Tuesday. Have good weekends. You know, call your guy if you have to, but be safe. And, you know, just live your decent, honest, God-fearing life. Help others. Tidy your room. Take on some responsibility and generally be... Oh, it is. Okay, cool. All right. See you Tuesday then. Love you all. God bless you. And just stay out of trouble. You know, be good to yourselves. All right. I love you.